Now let's get into some of these shapes here. We got the D shape, which is this one right here. We got called a recliner shape. Some call it the C shape. Actually, this is the C shape. Recliner shape is like this. That's the minor shape, is the recliner. The major shape is the C shape. You got the cascade shape. You got the D minor shape. You got what I call the L shape. The L shape turns into the A shape. A shape turns into the P shape. These two notes. You see the strings vibrating? Then you got the V shape. It's the upside down D. There's the D. The D, and there's the diminished seventh D. And you also have diminished seventh has a D minor shape. It all has an arrow shape. So I think we just covered all the shapes. So, oh, we got the E shape too. E shape because the E chord down here. Well, that's a major chord, so 1, 4, and 5 can hold an E shape. So we got the P shape. Well, let's just go from the top. A, we got the A shape. We got the C shape. Going alphabetically, we got the F shape. We got the P shape. We got the D shape, D minor shape. We got the L shape. We got the arrow shape. We got the recliner shape. And we got the V shape. So those are all the different shapes. That'll cover 3 notes per string. That's 3 notes per string arpeggio chords. You can do 3 notes per string on the first, second, third. Same chord, second, third, fourth strings. Same chord, third, fourth, and fifth string. Same chord, fourth, fifth, and sixth string. So this is an E. This is all one chord. E shape on the low strings, take it up a string. C shape on the fifth string. Next one, arrow shape. Remember, the arrow shape is also a diminished shape for that area. It's the same shape. There's a 1, diminished, a 1, it's the same shape. The D shape. Then, of course, we got the same chord. We can do an L shape because, you know, here's 1 there and 2 there. It makes an L going this way, an L shape. Then we have the F shape. This is the major for just 3 strings. Those 2 barred and 1 there. It's the shape of an F. So I just called it an F. And then when we get down here, that would be a P shape because there's a space in between there. So if it was right there, it'd be an F shape, but it's right there, so I call it the P shape. There's the stem, and then the P right here. That's pretty much all of them, but you can figure it out.